So today's section we are going to learn about the acrylic and polyester. And in the previous section we completed about what is the nylon and preparation properties and uses of nylon. The same way we studied about the acrylic too. So in the acrylic, so here we are talking about the acrylic rayon. So in the rayon also we studied about what is the preparation properties and the uses of the nylon and rayon. Now here in this section, acrylic and the polyester. So we are going to learn about what is an acrylic and the preparation and the uses. The same way, what is the polyester, the preparation and the uses. Now let us talk about acrylic. So in the winter season, what type of fiber we'll be selecting is wool. So we'll select the woolen cloths. But if you want the woolen cloths, it is possible. Yes, for you, it's possible because from one sheep you can take the woolen and you can make the woolen fiber. And you can use the as a woolen. But if you want the same woolen natural wool for so many people, number of people, is it possible? No, it's not at all possible. Why? Because that much of wool is required for preparing that many woolen fibers. So it becomes very difficult, and the yielding is also very difficult, and it's not at all easy to collect that much of wool. Okay, so for that case, we have the alternate wool, so that is only called acrylic, and this is known as fake fur. And whatever the woolen cloths and the sweaters, mufflers, gloves is what we are using in during the winter season, everything is made up of acrylic only, but not the real natural wool. Okay, we are referring only the acrylic. Okay, so this is known as the fake fur, and it is popular from the year 1941. So it is established and it is very popular during the 1941. So in that time, this particular time period almost, we are going on using this acrylic. So that is known as fake fur. So in this preparation, already in the previous classes we studied preparation process. So first of all, we are taking the polymers, which is treating with so many chemicals. Then it becomes like a syrup like viscous nature. Then after viscous, the polymers changes into the spindlet. Through the spindlet with the tiny small holes, so the thread, the fibers will be coming out. The same way here also, the spinnings are of two types. So I am not writing the complete process here because already the two sections we studied very detailed about the preparation. How the chemicals are treating with the polymers. So what are the polymers? Polymers indicates many units. Poly means many units, mer means units. So the polymers are treating with many chemicals. So when it is treating with many chemicals, it becomes like a viscous syrup. So that viscous syrup, again we are passing into the spindlet. Spindlet means a container which has small tiny holes. So it gives the shape and size for the fiber. So like that, the spinning process is taking place. But here the spinning is sort of two types. One is the dry spinning and one is the wet spinning. And wet spinning is very shorter period because already it is a wet, the polymers will be treated and it will be bathed and you will get the result fiber. So that is the dry fiber. But in the compared to the dry spinning, so here it is, the polymers are very dry in nature. So it will be treated with polymers and some other acids, and process will be takes place. Then it will be solidified with the warm air. Then we get the fibers by the evaporation of the water. So this is about the preparation of acrylic. Then next, come back to the uses. So it will be used in the jackets. So you will be wearing the jacket, socks, mufflers, and all the things we'll be using. The next one is the sportswear. And next one, sweaters. Just now I said, even for the vehicle covers. So you know that vehicle covers, for that also this particular acrylic will be used. So this is about the acrylic. And next, one more important thing. Do you know that when you are using the umbrella, what type of fiber we are selecting? Yes, you have idea. We are using the cotton. If you are using the cotton, what happens? It absorbs the water. So we are selecting the cotton? No. So what we are selecting? So we are selecting a fiber called waterproof fiber. So where the water is not absorbing and it is moving from the another place. So it is not at all allowing the water to come out, come inside. So that's what we are preferring the fiber. Preparing the fiber called nylon. So that nylon we are using for the waterproof cloth or fiber. Okay. And one more important thing. Till now, whatever we studied about the nylon, rayon, acrylic, in all the cases we studied what are the important disadvantage of the synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber will catches the fire very very fast. So this is the main disadvantage of the synthetic fiber. So this is about the alkylic. Now we'll talk about the polyester. So this polyester, when this polyester came to the world of the fiber, it becomes a major important role. So it takes the revolutionized the fiber industry and changed the costume culture. So whatever the costume culture is there till now, so it is completely vanished and it is occupied the place by the polyester. So the polyester becomes the main important role because it is very very thin in nature, very very viscous in nature, and it is very cheap and easy to wash and easy to dry. Okay, then come back to here, the blending process. So in the blending process, already we know what is the blending. The mixing of two or more fibers is known as blending, and you know why we are using the blending, to give the better fiber. Okay, so here also the polyester is taking the blending process with the another type of fiber. So here terylene. So terylene comes under the monomers, so which will be reacting with the cotton. So here the blending process is taking place with the terylene and the cotton, and you are getting the terikot. Terikot is some substances which is made up of mats or some other things. The same way terylene, when it is reacting with the, or else combining with the wool, so you are getting the terikots. So like this blending process is also taking place by the polyester. And next, preparation. So preparation of the polyester, till now this many sections we studied about how the preparation is taking place, the basic preparation. Okay, so here also the same basic preparation will be takes place from polymers by reacting with the some chemicals, then again it changes into solidified substances like viscous, then again you are giving the shape and the size by using the spinlet, then we are reacting with the chemicals, and here the chemical is, it is reacting with dicarboxylic acid with dihydric alcohol. So when it is reacting with this, then it will be started melting and then it forms into a spinning process. So like just now I said, a container which has small tiny holes, so that is called a spinlet, and here the tiny holes are ultra thin holes, means it is very very micro fibers, very very thin. So how much thin is, like how your hair is there, so more than this thin. Okay, if you see the hair, it is already very very thin, microfibric. So more than thin, this particular fiber is there. So this is about the polyester. So in this section we learn about what is alkylic. The other name of the alkylic is fake fear, and it is a replacement of the wool. Then we studied about the preparation, then we studied about the uses. Okay, and next we studied about the polyester. So in the polyester, I said that if this polyester takes the main important role in the fiber industries, then we studied about the blending process, how the blending is taking place with the terylene, with the cotton and the wool, and we got the terikot and the teriwool. Then next one, what are the substances, what are the chemicals we are using for the treating for the polymers, that is the dicarboxylic acid with treated with dihydric and alcohol. Then you are getting very very thin fibers, so that is called the ultra thin fiber, and we call it as microfiber. So this is about today's section, and tomorrow we are going to learn about next topic. So till now we are completed about the synthetic fibers. So what is the chapter name? Synthetic fibers and plastic. So till now we are completed about the synthetic fibers, and tomorrow section we are going to learn about plastics. Okay, so this is about today's section. Thank you.